Hello, this is the lecture number 8 for the chapter application of integrals, and we are discussing the miscellaneous exercise. And the last lecture we have done up to question number 2. Now let us start with question number 3. In this question you have to find the area lying in the first quadrant for the curve y is equal to 4x square and a bound and x is equal to 0, y is equal to 1 and y is equal to 4. So this is, if you see this curve carefully, this is a parabola which is symmetrical to y axis. X is equal to 0 means y axis, y is equal to 1 means a line parallel to x axis, and y is equal to 4 is also a line parallel to x axis. So you draw the curve for the parabola which is passing through the origin. Y-axis is this, x-axis is this, a line y is equal to 1 is somewhere here, which is parallel to y-axis, and a line y is equal to 4, which is again somewhere here, which is parallel to x-axis, and this line is also parallel to x-axis. You have to find the area bounded by this curve, these two lines, and x is equal to 0 means y-axis, that is in the first quadrant. You have to find this area. This point coordinates will be 0, 4, and this coordinate is 0, 1. So it's very easy to find its area. So area will be from 1 to 4, limits from 1 to 4 with respect to y and x. Because when we are integrating with respect to y, then we put the value of x. So x will be under root 2 upon 2 with respect to y, from 1 to 4. Like this you can integrate. X will be y upon 4 under root, that is this. So y raised to power 3 upon 2 upon 3 upon 2 half, this is 1 to 4. So this comes out to be 1 upon 3 y key power 3 upon 2 raised to power from the limit 1 to 4 to 1 upon 3 upper limit, that is y, that is 4 in place of y upper limit, 4 y raised to power 3 upon 2 minus 1 raised to power 3 upon 2. So this is 2 square 8 minus 1, which is 7 upon 3 square units is the area bounded by this curve y-axis and these two lines, which is parallel to x-axis. So this is the question number 3 of your miscellaneous exercise. See it carefully. Now question number 4, you have to find of this same exercise, that is miscellaneous exercise. It is given that you have to sketch the graph y is equal to mod x plus 3, and then you have to evaluate this integral, which is minus 6 to 0 mod x plus 3. Now if you see it carefully, you can't detect what the shape of the curve it is. So you have to sketch the graph for this from the limit from minus 6 to 0. So you can draw the solution set for this. X, y, minus 6, minus 5, minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0. So if it is minus 6, minus 5, minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0. You took the take the value of x from minus 6 to 0. If it is minus 6, so minus 6 plus 3 minus 3, minus 3 mod is 3. When you put minus 1, minus 5, it will be 2. When you put minus 4, it will be 1. When you put minus 3, it will be 0. When you put minus 2, it will be 1. It put minus 1, it will be 2. When 0, it will be 3. Now you can easily sketch this graph. One, two, three, four, five, six. That is minus 6, minus 5. This is minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0. So the value of y is maximum 3. y-axis and this is x-axis. Now mark these points. If it is minus 6, that is minus 3. This is the point. For minus 5, it is minus 2. For it is for minus 4, it is 1. This point. For minus 3, it is 0. For minus 2, again, it is equal to 1. For minus 1, it is 2. And for 0, it is 3. Now, if you see it very carefully, this graph is first of all decreasing, then it is increasing like this. And you have to find this area. This area you have to find. So, from the limit minus 6 to minus 3, if you see it carefully, this graph is decreasing, and from minus 3 to 0, it is increasing. So, you can find its area as from minus 6 to minus 3, this is decreasing, that is x plus 3 minus with respect to x. You have to put a minus sign because this function is decreasing. Plus minus 3 to 0, this function is increasing. This function is increasing from minus 6 to minus, from minus 6 to minus 3, it is decreasing, and from minus 3 to 0, it is increasing. And you know that the individually they will be positive mod sign because the area cannot be negative. So x square upon 2 plus 3 x limit from minus 6 to minus 3 plus x square upon 2 plus 3x limit from minus 3 to 0. This is x square upon, this is mod sign here, minus and mod sign, mod sign. The area cannot be negative. So x square upon 2 plus 3x, x square upon 2 plus 3x. Now when you solve it individually, upper limit minus lower limit, and upper limit minus lower limit, you are getting the area as 9 square units. Upper limit minus lower limit, upper limit minus lower limit. So this is somewhat different question, because by seeing the curve, we are unable to see the which type of the curve it is. So we have find it out here the solution set for this curve from the limit from minus 6 to 0. And from this graph, we are seeing that it is decreasing for in the interval minus 6 to minus 3. And from minus 3 to 0, it is increasing. So this is the question number 4 of the miscellaneous exercise. Now, in question number 5, in your miscellaneous exercise, you have to find the area bounded by the curve y is equal to sine x, that a sine function it is, from the limit x is equal to 0 and x is equal to 2 pi. Now, you know the sketch of the graph for sine x. You know it. It is 90, 180, 270, and 360. This is x-axis, this is y-axis. The value of maximum value of sine is 1, and the minimum value of sine is minus 1. For x is equal to 0, the value of sine is 0. For 90, it is 1. For 180, it is 0. For 3 pi by 2, it is minus 1. And from 2 pi, it is 0. So do you know that the sketch of the sine function is this, like this. And you have to find the area bounded by this curve from 0 to 2 pi. It means you have to find this area. This area you have to find, and these two areas are symmetrical. So you simply find the area bounded by the curve sine x from 0 to pi and multiply by 2. So its area will be twice 0 to pi and integrate sine x. So this is the total area bounded by sine x from 0 to 2 pi. So integrate it, it will be 2 minus cos x from 0 to pi. It will be minus ka cos pi up minus minus ka cos 0, upper limit minus lower limit. So it is minus minus 1 plus it is cos 0 is 1, so it is 2, 1 plus 1 is 2, that is 4 square units is the area bounded by these two curves, single curve, which is sine x from 0 to 2 pi. So this is the question number 5 of your miscellaneous exercise. That's it. Now let us take the question number 6. Now the question number 6 says that you have to find the area enclosed by this curve, which is 4ax, and the line y is equal to mx. Now we can easily detect from this what type of this curve is. Now first curve is a parabola which is symmetrical. This is a parabola which is symmetrical to the this is symmetrical to the x-axis, and this is a line which is passing through the origin. Now as usual, when there are two curves, when you solve them by any method, you will get the coordinates of x and y. You'll get x is equal to and y is equal to. You take your own time, you take your column to solve these equations by any method. You are getting the x as 4a upon m square and y as 4a upon m. 4a upon m. So it means the point of intersection of these two curves, which is in which one is the parabola and one is the straight line which is passing through the origin, and this is the first, and you're also getting x is equal to 0 and y is equal to 0. Then you solve that. So you draw it. This is the this first curve, which is a parabola symmetrical to the x-axis, and the point of intersection of the line is 0, 0, and the point, let us take this point as 4a upon m square and 4a upon m. This is the point of intersection. The line will pass through this, and this is the coordinate of this point. So this is the area you have to find. So as usual, when you draw a perpendicular on the x-axis, the coordinate will be 4a upon m square 0. On x-axis, y coordinate is 0. So from this you can easily detect, first of all you have to find the area bounded by this curve, which is a parabola from 0 to 4a upon m square. You will get this total area touching with the x-axis, this total area. You can say that OA, if you say it B, OAB minus area of OAB. So OA, this triangle OAB. Now the area OAB, which is touching the curve, will be obtained by integrating this y square is equal to 4ax from the limit 0 to 4a upon m square. So its area will be from 0 to 4a upon m square y with respect to x of the curve first, that is parabola, minus again 0 to 4a upon m square with the line. So parabola minus line is the area, required area. So what is the value of y here? It will be y of this will be under root 4ax from 0 to this 4a upon m square minus y of this line is mx from with respect to x. It will be 0 to 4a upon m square. So as usual, it is 2 root a, and the you have to integrate root x with respect to x here, and here you have to integrate x. So this is the area bounded by these two curves, and when you integrate it, it will be x to the power 3 by 2 upon 3 by 2 0 to 4a upon m square minus m x square upon 2 from 0 to 4a upon m square. Now upper limit minus lower limit, when you do it, upper limit minus lower limit, upper limit minus lower limit, so you will get here 8a square upon it will be 3m cube. So this is the area bounded by these two curves. Say it carefully, it will be. Question number 6 of the miscellaneous exercise. You take your own calculation in your rough column, you will be able to get this. Main thing is the sketching of the curve, taking the limits, which area from which curve you have to subtract which curve or add which curve. Okay, we'll discuss in the next lecture. Thank you.